Hello, in this video we're going to be having a look at some of the advanced variances that are examinable for CIMA P2 Advanced Management Accounting. And the two sets of advanced variances we're going to be looking at in this short video are mixing yield variances and planning and operational variances. So let's start off then by looking at mixing yield. Traditionally we would calculate variances for materials based on price and usage. Now, if there are more than one materials input into a process and there is an element of substitutability, between those products, then, so for example, we might have going into a pasta sauce that we're going to be having a look at in a minute. We might have some tomatoes and some onions going into a pasta sauce. You could have more onions and less tomatoes, and that would be a difference in mix. And it makes sense to consider the impact then of a difference in mix. What we're not going to be looking at here is, for example, if you're making cars, it would be an odd thing to say to say you can substitute steering wheels for tyres. You couldn't really have one more steering wheel and one less tyre. It just wouldn't work. So if there's an element of substitutability between the materials, you've got more than one material, then we can have a look at the impact of the inputs being in a different mix to a standard and the financial impact of that. And then also the yield, the results, what came out, the outputs from the process compared to what should have come out. So the mix and the yield variances between them are a sub-analysis of the usage variance. So that means if you add together mix and yield, you should get back to your traditional usage variance. Easiest to see, as always, I think, by looking at an example. So we're going to have a look at that pasta sauce example now. So what we've got on the left-hand side here is the standard cost card. So this is the standard recipe for one batch of pasta sauce. We have a kilo of onions goes in there, and we have a kilo of tomatoes. The onions are relatively inexpensive at $2 a kilo, the tomatoes $4 a kilo. So the cost of one batch of pasta sauce is $6 worth of materials. So that's our standard, that's our budget, that's our recipe. What actually happened in the period we're going to be looking at is we made 550 batches using 600 kilos of tomatoes and 530 kilos of onions. So I can already tell in terms of the mix there that we've used more onions than tomatoes, and in the standard mix it was equal amounts of each one. So that must mean it's a more expensive mix. I'm expecting not good news when it comes to the mix variance. So mix variance, first of all, then is trying to look at the financial impact of the inputs having gone into the cooking process at a different mix to standard. So first of all, here's our actual mix. We actually put in 530 kilos of onions and 600 kilos of tomatoes. So in total, 1,130 kilos of material went in. What we're looking at now is that 1,130 kilos in total that went in. If that went in the standard mix and that was half and half, onions and tomatoes, then that would have been 565 kilos of each. All we've done there is take the 1,130 total inputs and split it 50-50 between the two. Okay, so we've got actual inputs did take and actual inputs should take. I suppose we could change the word from take to mix there. Actual input did mix and actual input should mix. So we've got for onions, the actual inputs did go in, 530, should have done 565. So we've used 35 less onions than the standard mix. Well, that's good news in itself. Multiply that by the standard price, because this isn't a price variance, so it's always valued up at standard, just like the usage variance is, gives us $70 favourable variance on onions. But when we look at tomatoes, we actually used 600 kilos of tomatoes compared to the standard recipe of 565. So we were 35 over there, and they are more expensive. So 35 times $4 is 140 adverse. So overall, we've got an adverse mix variance because we're using more of a more expensive ingredient. So mix, inputs focused. Yield, what's come out given what's gone in. So our standard cost card said we needed 2 kilos of materials to produce one batch. So given that 1,130 kilos went in, we would have expected that to produce, divide that by two, 565 batches. What it did yield was 550 batches. Which is not great again. That's 15 batches less than we would have expected. Now, we aren't concerned about the mix of that 1130 because this isn't the mix variance. We've already looked at that. So we're just looking at it in total. And we value that up. Remember, that's 15 batches of pasta sauce. And the standard cost of a batch of pasta sauce was $6. So 15 times 6 gives us a adverse yield variance of $90. So if I take the mix and yield variance and add them together, that comes up to my overall usage variance on materials, 90 plus 70 is 160 adverse. Now, you can apply this to labour as well, actually. So you'd use different grades of labour as opposed to different types of material, but you do very similar calculations there. So that's mix and yield then. The other set of variances we're going to look at is planning and operational variances, which is essentially correcting the budget to make it a fair benchmark. What we traditionally do is compare the actual results with our original budget, our flexed original budget, and say, is it favourable or adverse? What we're saying now is if the budget needs revising because of either a mistake in the original budget or things outside the organisation's control have happened, like the market shrunk or the worldwide price of something has gone up, something like that, then we should correct the budget for those things before we actually use them to assess our actual performance. So what we do, first of all, is correct the budget. And that's what we're going to call a planning variance. And then once you've corrected the budget, you then compare the actual results to that corrected budget. And that's what we call the operating variance. The planning variance plus the operating variance should come back to the traditional variance overall. But what we're doing here is ensuring we've got the correct accountability, because the people who produce the actual results should be held accountable for the operating variances, and the people who put the plans together should be held accountable for the planning variances. Let's have a look at an example. So if we had an original budget of 10,000 kilos of material at $5 a kilo, and that comes to $50,000. Let's suppose we actually purchased 11,000 kilos at $5.50 a kilo, so that would come to $60,500. So the traditional variance would just be to compare. Suppose, though, there was an error in the original budget and it should have said $6.10 rather than $5. Let's say the world price of this material went up over the period. It's not fair to assess actual performance with that original $5 if it's now out of date. So what we're going to do first of all is correct that to $6.10. So we always flex to actual. So 11,000 kilos originally cost $5 in the original budget, but now we're going to correct that to $6.10. So that means that we're going to increase the cost for what we would have expected to have to pay to 67,100. And now that's an adverse variance because it's increasing our costs. All planning variances are bad news, whether they're technically favourable or adverse, because it just means the plans weren't right, that's all. But 12,100 is a planning variance. It would need to see the person who put the budget together to discuss that. Now we've corrected that benchmark to 67,100, we can now use that as a fair benchmark for comparing to our actual performance. So actually a fair benchmark is $6.10. It actually only cost us $5.50. So by the time we multiply those each by 11,000 kilos, that comes out to be 6,600 favourable. So in actual fact, our operational performance was very good because the world price went up to $6.10 and we managed to get it for $5.50. So what started off as looking like bad operational performance of 5,500 traditional adverse variance there, once we've split it into the planning and operational elements, we can actually see this is a planning issue. Operationally, we actually performed quite well. Now, the last thing I would say about planning variances is that correcting the original budget should be exceptional. It should be unusual, because what you don't want is for it to get to be a habit in the organisation of people being able to say, oh, well, the budget was wrong. That's why actual is not looking great, because the budget was wrong in the first place. The budget is supposed to be, you know, of course, it's not right because it's not actual. No one ever said it had to be actual. It was just a statement of what you think the cost is going to be at a point in time to give you that yardstick, that fair benchmark to compare to actual performance. So it should be exceptional so it doesn't undermine the original budget as a fair target. So that's our new variances for paper P2 Advanced Performance Management or Advanced Management Accounting. We've looked there at planning and operating variances and mixing yield. I hope that's been useful to you. And I hope the studies are going well. Best of luck with the real exam.